no matter how many actions you take, you never get enough actions about the dead validation, so that that becomes quality model. To become an isomorphism, a pure validation model, but to not be the capital. Well, we can do that in measurement. In finding quality, it's great, because once you have quality, you can define lots of things with equality. You don't have to define lambda calculus, mu calculus, larger fixed points, least fixed points, and and the trick, I shouldn't go into all detail, unless you really want to, but I'll tell you the intuition. The intuition is that construct like lambda, like in function programming, like lambda production, they achieve two major important properties at the same time. One is that they build the third, lambda xe, that's the third. Right? And two, they build the binding. They bind that x, right, all the current, three current of x in the body of the function. Two other things. Right? We know how to do both of them, right? Because naturally, you have to put a symbol on both of things to build the structure, to build the third, and then you have to go for binding. So then what we do is fit this atomic operation into two smaller operations, one that builds the binding, and the other one which builds the third. Right, and another symbol, let's say we actually this is only symbol, lambda zero, we have a symbol lambda zero, that's pair x and d. And then we use the exponential quantifier in front of it, we have used the binding. And now we use lambda x e as an area for this pattern. And notice you cannot write that in front of the logic, right? Because this is a term, and you cannot put a quantifier in front of a term, put a quantifier in front of a thing. We are going to take by simpler. And then the inequality is definable, then you find other values to know. Then you can define new fixed points the same way. And this is this equation, the main equation of fixed points, but it's not telling you yet that it's a listed point. But then what you can do is to add metrologic values of the connected value here, which is the listed point here, to look like this. So then if I have psi as a fixed point of t, then mu is going to be more. That makes mu the more fixed point. So can you define all this? Well, once you have fixed points, then you can define motor logic, core logic, dynamic logic, evaporation logic, and more importantly, the stability logic, which was the logic previously used for the logic. All right. So what is K now? K is literally a best effort implementation of Jabriti logic, but Jabriti logic, same as this other logic, now can be defined in K. Right? I'm not going to show you how. But just trusting that that natural logic has been explaining everything K does. So every single operation that the execution engine interpreter, the logic engine, the debugger, the inductive program modifier, everything can be explained. And the way the game Kruger works is that, because I can have other verifiers, you have a program verifier giving you a program specification, but now I can actually filter the instantiate my Kruger with a programming language, but in the semantics, the program is T, but then I pass T into my verifier in Java, and it's done Java. So I make the program, and then the K verifier, basically using the semantics of the programming language, and all sorts of heuristics. This is a problem in domain reasoning that's unavoidable. That's where the computer part comes from. We're like an oracle for the domain. We use natural numbers in the domain, and there are different complex properties of all natural numbers. So we still have to, you know, to have a solver for domain properties and use this thing there. Let's see, K, think of K as the key verifier. Tool to eliminate the program language from the picture and reduce the quantification problem to a problem in the mathematical domain and program language domain. And now we have to do for the coaching to instantiate the verifier with this new language for the domain and so on. And in terms of performance again, the performance of the it by defining the complete semantics of the EVM in the case, the same way we define it. And everything we do in terms of semantics, and even the case that we call open source, can go to the GitHub version framework. And like all the other semantics, we test it by running all the tests that we put our hands on. In particular, the Kenyan Foundation provides a C++ implementation of the EVM, the data formatting manual to run. And that comes with 40,000 tests. We ran on those. So I was surprised that we could ran on those. But I knew that the test was already covered in the past. But I was surprised because of the problem. They did get that with your camera. Camera is really great. It turned out it was only 20 slower, 30 times slower than the C++ implementation. And that's because there were also several stress tests. When we made those stress tests, there were only 10 times actually. There were like 20 programs or so for those which were really, you know, stressed to go through both modes of time. But yeah, one order of magnitude slower than actual handcrafting C++ implementation. To make it look bad, you don't care about anything about EVM. But when you think about it, it's completely generated from a mathematical model of the language. That's really a big deal. Such a big deal that IHK is actually so expedient that they decided to start a blockchain, basically. A testnet for now. There is a testnet. You go to on our website and follow the links there, you will see that you can actually run smart contracts right now on the EVM. And you can send your smart contracts, ready them, and run everything on EVM, on the EVM. Yes, before you qualify construction client, yes, there could be lots of errors on your hood, but again, there is no single line of code written by human in the web support, but for the actual launch game. And one day, you will and of course, there's been the popular and so on, but there's not so different.
So, at the end of the day, like, I mean, of course, Kim, awesome, really cool. But at the end of the day, what they're doing is basically adding a literature that has some questions about what should not happen for those human instructions, right? You could obviously think of creating a solution in another way and, you know, make it go money.
Yeah, that's the cool part, right? And we really don't know 20
might become a problem in the future, because what you can do, because you have a smart contract, you can choose to basically do something in another smart contract, and that smart contract might do something in another smart contract, and right. if somehow that basically becomes, I don't know, 1,000, 100,000 lines of code of execution for one call, that could be a problem.
Yeah. But
that's going to be for everybody, and that's going to be a problem that you have to solve.
That being said, there are companies that are whose main task is level of virtual machine for EPM. Right. The company called, I think, Aon in Canada. And we are actually in discussion with them, because the level rate somehow from a very high, but huge task. Right. But yeah, the product, but this is the thing, you know, you ask all the questions, you know, but I have a future work. The product is not supposed to do future work. So there's one thing you can do with the product one, right? Generate the actual EPM. Directly from the semantic. Another thing that we do, and this is what we mainly do, the guy running my company, that's where most of our revenue comes from the company right now, is to verify smart contracts. Okay? So there are companies which want to deploy their smart contracts, like those we saw before, and they don't want their stupid part. Or at least they want to tell their clients that they don't want their stupid part, because they show the power report, and then they allocate like the whole thing, the power properties report, and so on. Yeah, you go to our webpage and go to solutions, give the smart contract education and explain their how we do it. And the way we do it is that we discuss with the developers of the smart contract for hours, sometimes days, they should come to our place, sometimes for the regulatory engineer for 1 week, when, where we try to understand what they want to implement there. And then we explain them, and then we explain them probably what they want to do for the and we find actually many bugs of that page, right? So that week for them is already, you know, worth the money. And then once we have all the certification, we have all this disclaimer at that moment that everything wrong in those certifications is not our fault, but our fee. And then from there, we verify the code in the certified certification, right? So you know that if you're a hacker, now you know where to attack. You know, you should not attack the code, you should attack the country.
The specifications are written in which language? Okay. The formal specification. Thank you.
Just a rule. What I can write a rule is that if the demand of 5 minutes in month here, or, you know, last piece of code, it's the same thing. Still, I'm jumping the rule. I start with this, I reach this. Yeah, that's what I think. It's the same format. It's also for both semantics and property.
Wait, when you're saying, okay, what is it? What did you try to optimize? The expressiveness of the framework, the ease of specification of the semantics, the performance of the verifiers in the
quality.
And what is the biggest challenge? To me,
the biggest challenge for us was, believe it or not, syntax, how to do syntax. One, because it's complex syntax. And they have to, so we have to design parsers that can parse rules in place, which contains syntax from your language and syntax of K, all these together, and to figure out which is used and so on. And then when we write a paper, no one cares about syntax anyway. But that was the biggest challenge for us. Then another big challenge is to generate the right queries to T3. Right, so when we decide that it's time to get out of K and now ask T3 for a solution, then we have to make sure to get the right format. And sometimes we have to get the wrong format. And syntax, yes, now we have an XML-like notation, and many people just don't like XML at all, not by design, and you know, we are already thinking of it in automatic syntax for this. Okay, it's funny, spend a lot of time, you know, with the mathematics, that's one of the people care about syntax. All right, yeah, so also because of this, we listen to one of the Ethereum Foundation, which is very fantastic, which is, I'm very glad about. We worked with them for the time in the past, and now we were hired to make like that. All right, and now we go to this part. So yes, we define EPM, we learn from EPM. We learn what it means to define actual virtual machine, what it means to generate a virtual machine. And then we verify lots of contracts, and we also learn how like to design a new language, a new virtual machine language, where verification would be easier, where programs in that virtual machine, if you try to read EVM programs, you don't understand anything, because it's a text-based machine, you want to push, pull, or dot one, push three, and so on. You don't understand anything. That's what you're doing. So a few ideas here, you get a few ideas, you have LLVM, you may have heard of LLVM, and we really like the idea, or the philosophy of the idea. We have like a register-based machine, and then we have a computation pipeline, and addition, separately translation to the end from actual efficient compilation from there on. So what if we have something similar for the blockchain? And we talked to IHK, in particular their CEO, Charles Hutchinson, and we told him that, hey, you like EDM, you are one of the founders of Ethereum, but shouldn't we try to go to the next level, to a better machine? That they wanted to avoid all the problems of EDM that we learned formally. And one day, actually, the program to chat in more video, like in LLVM. You can look at the program, you see functions, you see labels, you see jumps, you can look at the code and understand what's going on. I would like to use such a language if I can create my program, smart contract, as I said. And actually, he was extremely excited about that, and he said that he wanted EVM from the beginning, he used the base machine, but in the end, the other decided to use the tech-based machine, so he was all for it. And then we started a project to, and I was particularly very excited that the designer of the Remus on the framework, that gave us the chance for the first time ever to design a programming language formally, completely, from scratch. Like, you know, like the implement was an interpreter from the same open market. Now, we designed from the beginning the language in case formally, the same way these other languages before. The difference was that this was a new language and the real language. In the past, all the real languages that we defined were already there, were existing languages, or otherwise were like toy languages, different languages of speech. And this was for the first time a real language. And it was a great experience, very exciting. And we actually took less than I think it could have taken much longer than the rest of the people. It took us 2 months, almost a year, 2 months. Yeah, so it was quite fast. But everybody was super excited working on it. We knew that we do something new for the first time. And then we generated the VM, IHK decided to start another testnet, which would happen here in July, that will run DLF at the main VM. And also, I don't know, actually we implemented a compiler from Solidity to DLF, which was the previous compiler that was from Solidity to VM, because it don't like DLF or VM in general. It is a compiler from private language. So we modified the Solidity to VM compiler to generate DLF. And we can now run your 20 contract on the other. And we are still measuring performance, are still improving actually the backend of case, generally better and better part and part of code. But I think we are like twice or so faster than the team. So that means we're like 5 times or so slower than but you could probably implement by hand if you talk about that. All right, there are several other languages that we are working on for the blockchain. One is WebAssembly. Actually, the Ethereum Foundation itself decided to drop EVM. They are not going to support EVM anymore. But they didn't choose EVM, they chose WebAssembly. They are defining the semantics of WASM. Now they probably start to also work. And they even use cake. The guy who's working with it, so it's defining WASM, he's still defining, he's working on a company, so something complicated thing. But the point is that the Ethereum Foundation is that it's not up. It's not a verification of the economics of WASM. It's them, but it is the one that's for the now, when we also define the semantic of Solidity, Bluetooth is a functional language that will be designed by IHK, has to like language for the blockchain. Okay. on to the next. And now the whole development is in Haskell. And as I said before, actually, we use your Camel Bacon, which is great. Camel is a great language, but it's still very price. Camel is more general than we need. And we believe we can generate much more efficient matching than for Camel with a specialized working. It may look like the time to run the rate system goes into applying the rate rules, but no, the time doesn't get spent there. The time gets spent where I wish we would go back to the matching. So when we have 25,000 rules, instead we do the matching, that's the 25. Now we have a very specialized and then we use the implementation pipeline. So that's what we want to do next. And another thing we want to do is, so once we do, I think once we have the backend, we'll be able to generate code, which will be comparable in performance for the few write by hand, if you're writing the by hand, and keep us up. I think at that moment, we'll complete the hand traffic implementation. And if that happens, that will be a huge switch, I think, mental switch. Like now, why should you write the code in assembly? Right? When you have a key, that's not by the generic, probably better for it. That's really good.
Sorry, OCaml doesn't have a native code compilation.
It does.
Because normally, I mean, I think there's the interpreter embedded in the executable, things like this.
No.
So, okay, I didn't know. So probably the performance of OCaml could be really good.
No, we squeezed a lot of performance, but we were in discussion with OCaml, right? Because we found lots of bugs in OCaml. So we had to make pull requests to make OCaml.
Okay. Okay. So then the problem is
really, we know exactly what the problem is. The problem is in the pattern nature.
Okay.
The pattern nature does more work than we need.
That's it.
Yeah, we profile it.
Thanks.
All right, so anyway, so you automatically can go from that program based on the semantics of that language to that program, and then from that you can then generate, you know, you can run that program to those input. And in some experiments, we've seen improvements speed up. Typically more than 10 times, right? Which is kind of what you expect, like the local interest of the compiler expects another magnitude. So, all right, we're working on that. And finally, the most important thing for me, with my partition, is two-party generation. Every single tool that we have in the framework can be thought of as a unique search for a tool, even if we should, the tool. drop classes there, that you can drop the class.
So how difficult is it? Of course, for you, the part will not be the problem, right? But the question is, like, for normal programs, how difficult is the specification that you require for, you know, all these magic to happen?
I can tell you that maybe 25% of the students drop the class, even because they don't like it, but because they think they can do well. But I can also tell you that I find first year students who are pretty good, and they fall in love with it, right? When they do all their, they spend all their time in all of them, and then they also go for PhD. Once you like it, you like it. So I don't know. And there are also people who maybe don't be more appropriate to us. That's what we indicate for teaching the faculty. It's not as hard as a conventional paradigm. It's actually a lot simpler than a conventional language, because if you have only one case of the root, the right root, you find everything with the right root. But it's your creativity, imagination, and like in anything else, you can write best. Best amount. We are actively reducing the program. Like implementing cloud.